The devil went down to Georgia. He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind and he was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man sawing on a fiddle and playing it hot, and the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you'd care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul, cause I think I'm better than you." The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet and you're gonna regret, cause I'm the best as ever been. Johnny, rosin up your bow and play your fiddle hard, cause hell's broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, you get this shiny fiddle made of gold, but if you lose, the devil gets your soul."
No cigarette
for you.
Fucker.
That's right. Fucker. Alright, we are back.
I could just diva out of this bitch right now and go smoke a cigarette.
Nope.
Diva.
Probably shake your ass while you're walking there.
Nope, nope.
You always do this. You never.
No, I don't always do this. If I don't do this, then it doesn't get done.
I just one more smoke.
No, and there's no mulligans, hooligans, fooligans, benigans, whatever the fuck it is.
Fiddle faddles.
Mm-mm.
No benigans.
We alive, we're going. We're recording. So say, start us off.
And we're back for another episode of Background Noise with me, Drew, the huge dick Watt guy. And then you got D, the huge dick black guy. And then we got Ben, the huge dick Jew guy. He's circumcised.
So you got a nigga, a ginger, and a Jew.
I'm a half ginger, motherfucker.
Oh, man. So how you doing, man?
I'm doing pretty good, man.
So good to have you.
Yeah.
Come on the podcast, but it seems like... we're advancing now. Now we have two guests.
Yeah.
2 weeks in a row.
Wow. I just couldn't help but come talk shit.
Awesome. And then my Jew friend here tonight, we're going to call him Diablo Blanco.
Damn it.
And that's
the white devil.
That's his anonymous name because we're going to tell some fucked up stories.
Diablo Blanco.
Diablo Blanco.
Now that y'all know my name and my anonymous name.
Did I already say your name? I'm pretty sure I just said Jew. I think you're just so used to hearing Jew as your nickname.
Oh, I think you said it, but we'll be alright.
I'm a name dropper. It's this habit I have. I can't.
I know. It's like, what's fucked up is like, like I've said it before, like, if you get caught up with him, right? And he just can't help it, man. He's the guy on the first 48. He just like, he can't help it. That's just Drew. He just,
yeah, Drew's definitely the guy you don't bring around your parents. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but tell you what, when it comes to the police, I don't snitch.
True.
I don't snitch. Drew don't snitch.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the only time I don't drop names. If we're on a radio show, you might get chewed out by your girlfriend. Or your friends might look at you and be like, "That's fucked up. I can't believe you did that." Yeah, I'll do that. I'll drop your name in the middle of that shit. But you know what? If you're a cop, I don't know shit. Okay? When I got caught with weed, they took me in. I shit you not, dude, for like 3 hours. They're like, "Where the fuck did you get that shit?" I said, "I grew it." Yeah. I said, "What?" "Yeah, I grew it." They're like, "You grew it." They're like, "Well, earlier," they even tried to fuck with it. They're like, "Well, earlier you said you were selling it. You said that, you know, you're distributing friends." And I did. I did say that. But I knew. No, listen. I knew when I told them that.
Yes, said it.
Look, I knew when I told them that it wouldn't record. I mean, they were handcuffing. We were all standing outside. Fucking, this was at a time when not every cruiser had cameras and shit on them.
Deny,
filming at all times and
deny,
shit.
Deny.
Yeah, and I know I said it, but I had planned it. I was like, I'm going to say it because that's what they want to hear. I don't want them to fuck with me. You know, so fucking they got what they wanted to hear. They fucking cuffed me, and sure enough, they didn't say a fucking word to me or treat me bad the whole time till they booked me in. When they booked me in, they put me in a little room. Fucking detective come in and sit down. I was like, you know, well, like, you know, the amount of weed you have, you know, it's not a normal amount. Where are you getting it? I said, I grew it. He said, well, said, one of the officers said he heard you earlier say that you sound like you and a friend. I said, no, he misunderstood me. I said, I was growing it. I was getting it ready to smoke with some friends. And he said, oh, okay. He's like, so you grew it, huh? So you didn't get it from nobody. He said, no. He said, well, why do you think we pulled you over? We know what you've been doing. I said, well, if you know what I've been doing, why am I sitting here trying to explain shit to you? Shit you not. Because I hate them. And I'm already in trouble. I'm already in trouble, you know. I don't give a fuck. I'm going to give you an attitude. Oh, what are you going to do?
Yeah,
put me in a cell and not allow me to go anywhere? Oh, wait. I'm already headed there. Like, fuck them.
So I said that to him. Exactly, and he legal.
He, yeah. But so he was pretty upset, and he left the room, and they did the wait out thing. They made me sit in there for like an hour or two, just like fucking sitting there, literally. Like, and then he comes back in. You sure you don't want to tell me? I said, yeah, look, I'll tell you. I grew it. I said, I'll go take you where I grew it. I'll take you right now. I'll show you the dirt where I dug it up and everything. And he was like, really? And I said, yeah. I said, I'll take you there. We'll go right now. I'll show you where I grew it. And so, of course, he tried to call my bluff, and he was like, all right, I'm going to go talk to the officers. We're going to get it ready, and we'll go and take you out there. I said, okay. I sit there and waited. About another hour later, he popped in, and he was like, all right, go to, you go, you're going, basically, to fucking holding. Like, so I went into a fucking cell, and I sat there, and I fucking literally was in there maybe like 32 hours and got bonded out. I was like, fuck off, guys. And then what makes that story even better is I won't get into like heavy detail because it's a long story, but for almost about 3 years, once a month, I held off court by demanding that I didn't want a court appointed, that I wanted to try to afford my own lawyer. I did that shit for 3 years till finally when they fucking saw that it had been 3 years, they're like, oh, you don't have a choice. You got to go in there, lawyer or not. So I went in there without a lawyer, G'd that shit out. She said, I'm going to give you about 12 months probation. You're going to pay about $300 a month for your probation plus your drug testing. And if you do good, then, you know, everything will rest and get it off your system. I said, no, man, you put me in jail right now. She was shocked as fuck. I swear to God, she was an Asian woman. I swear to God, it almost seemed like she seen a ghost when I said that. Because I didn't do it like the normal, like, I don't give a fuck, lock me up. I was just like, real respectfully, like, no, man, just go ahead and take me to jail. She's like, what? And so I basically was like, well, yeah, this is the way I see it. Weed's the only thing that makes me function like a normal human being. And I know that seems taboo to you, because, you know, what you do for a living and shit and how you make your revenue. But I was like, but it's the only thing that makes me get up and go to work. It's the only thing that keeps me from fucking snapping. It's the only thing that makes me not seem so depressed. It's the only thing that makes all this fucking worth doing. You know, of course I didn't say fucking, but, you know, all worth doing. And she was just like, you really mean that? I said, I do. So I said, if that's the case, you just go ahead and put me in jail now, because I guarantee you when I get back out, I might not be selling or anything, but I'll be smoking it.
Not only that, but probation is nothing but, in my opinion, just about fucking
you. It's a trap. It's about hoping you'll fuck up so they can fuck you even more. So once I balls up like that, it was basically like put me in jail, she wasn't having it. So she found every way around it. And then the funny thing is, she was like, well, can you come up with $600 by the end of this week? I said, yes, ma'am, I can. She said, all right, you come in, you know, we'll meet at the end of the week, you pay $600 down on everything or whatever they want to charge me for the shit that happened. And fucking, we'll put you on deferred adjudication. And it'll go off your record if you don't fuck up for 3 years. I told her, okay. I said, I went out. Well, I didn't tell her this, but I went out. I sold a shitload of weed. Made about $600. Fucking went and paid it off. Got that shit on my record.
That's the way you're supposed to do it. Good job, man. I'm proud of you, man.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome, but I mean, as much as I want to be like, oh yeah, it saves money and time, like, well, no, I had to waste time and money to go up to fucking court every month for 3 fucking years. In a way, I did pay.
Right.
Like, I still paid. I can't say, haha, I got off scot-free, but I didn't pay the way they wanted me to pay, and I'm satisfied with that.
Yeah, yeah, I refused to pay probation.
Yeah.
No, you can give it. Go ahead and give me the time.
Yeah, just I'll take the time. Nine times out of ten, they don't want you to go. Not unless you're a hardened criminal. If you're not a hardened criminal, they're just like, well, we don't want to waste the time. Like, it almost costs us more money to keep your ass in there.
No,
like,
just give us a couple TV dinners and some paper towels and shit. And yeah. We'll just call it even.
Look, this is what I used to do. But like, look, you're all a bunch of good looking cops. Alright, I know this black neighborhood, you shoot at least 4 of them, ain't nobody even gonna know, you just go down there, get your anger out. Then we all high five and talk about TV dinners and fucking, you know, rebel flags and shit. You know, touch each other's butts. Not gay.
You do look like the type of dude that would do that, man.
Really? Do you think so?
Yeah, man, you got the beard and everything.
Well, when I see myself, I don't see that. I see more like a person that would probably smoke pot and eat a donut out of your trash can.
Nah, I could.
I see a porn addict.
You look like a cross between Zach Galifianakis and Bobby Hill.
That's funny. You know, you say that, and I think that's kind of a lamer version. But I like to see myself as, and this is something that I've always said, is I look like a mix between Zach Galifianakis and Grizzly Adams.
Yeah, that's true too. Yeah.
Do you think that's a good thing?
It's better than Bobby Hill.
Yeah, I suppose.
But you know what? If I did shave off this beard, I probably would look like Bobby. All you ladies listening out there, it's not true.
I know my white people, man.
He knows I love cheeseburgers.
You're transitional.
D had to tell me what it was like to be white for a minute. Because I remember one day I was like, what are white people foods? He started naming them off and I was like, oh shit. Like all my white senses started going there. And I was like, he's right.
Oh, that's awesome.
Cheeseburgers, wolf chili. Like,
no, but all right, there's three B's that white people love, right?
Butter.
Burgers, bacon, beer.
Yes.
See, four. See, yeah. Butter.
No.
Butter. We put butter on everything. They even put it in our coffee now. It's
top four. It's top four.
The beer.
But it's top four. But it's burgers, bacon, beer. Those are the top three. The top three B's for white people.
Yeah, that's true, because my white ass family in the morning, if the bacon gets all eaten and someone misses out on the bacon train, it's always like one cranky ass person.
That's kind of ironic, because my initials are BBB. So that works out.
See? Yeah. There you go.
Dang.
Yeah.
I mean, it's your super white. Yeah, right. You wish you could be white. You're Jewish.
Yeah.
That's a race, motherfucker, not a religion.
Actually, Hebrew is a
It's a religion, not a race. I was kidding.
But it's kind of like both, though, right?
Not at all.
Well, technically,
what is it? Judaism is a religion, right?
Right. Judaism is a religion.
And then the actual race is Hebrew.
It is Hebrew, yes.
Actually, it would be an ethnicity. Jews.
Because their ethnicity is
right.
Hebrew.
See, I get technical.
Well, no, that's good though. If we're gonna be talking about it, we need to get it right.
Okay, I learned this in school. There are only three races.
Okay.
There's black, white, Asian. Everything else is ethnicity.
Okay. Why is that? Why is there only three main?
There's only three races. White, black, Asian. That's it.
Mexicans get screwed.
And then, yeah, the Mexicans are like a mixture of Asian and...
Yeah.
And
so, like, Brazilian and Spaniards and all that
everything
shit?
Everything comes from one of those three.
So
everything
so
comes
originally,
from ethnicity.
So, originally, the original three races... Well, I thought Caucasians came from Asians.
Well,
the Caucasus
Mountains. White and...
Caucasians.
No.
Asians.
Caucasians.
No, nah, they didn't... You would think that, but no, that's not it.
Caucasians.
But we all started out as Negroes.
Well, remember that crazy guy I used to tell you about that came into the smoke shop? He was a racist black dude, hated white people, but he respected me because I'd let him, white rants to me. Not talk shit to me. He was respectful about it. Because if he wasn't, I wouldn't sit there and listen to it. But he'd just be like, hey, man, hear me out. You seem like a reasonable person. Hear me out. This is why black people are way more superior than white people. Like, you fuck your animals. But his original thing was like, you know, one thing he always liked to push on me, and I'd give him a little bit of a hard time about it, you know, but he'd be like, you know what white people kiss their dogs and their cats and then, you know, just whatever animal they own, they want to, like, kiss up on them and hug them. Black people aren't like that. And I'm like, why? And he was basically like, because a long time ago, when Asians migrated away from the black people, they split up. They were starting to move away and get into colder climates, and their skin was starting to get a lot lighter. Because everyone started from Africa. They were all black. You know, which that could be possible. No, I'm not doubting true. That one bit. I'm not saying there wasn't some truth in what he said, but there's a lot of fucking holes in this story. But
there's probably some canyons.
I love this guy. Most people are like, how can you let him say those things? Like, how can you not get offended? It's like, man, you don't know me. Like, I live for this type of shit. Like, but he came and he basically broke it down. He's like, well, and his story went, you know, they separated and started kind of like wandering and shit. Well, they found this place out in the mountains that they really liked in the springtime, and they decided to make it their home. Well, it got so bad in the winter, they were trapped and they couldn't go anywhere, do anything, and they get bored and lonely and started like fucking their animals and shit. And because they were always in the snow and in the cold and hiding and shit, they lost a lot of their pigment, and that's how we got this white colored skin. And so that's why white people like to make out with their dogs, and we're so white.
That's a very colorful story.
I thought so. I wish I could find him.
I mean, I agree.
I honestly wish I could find the guy. I really do, and bring him on and let him just go to town. Because he's, for one thing, he's a cool guy. Like, he's not just cool to hang out with. You know, I mean, like, out, like inside the shop, like, he's cool to hang outside with. Because there was times when we would meet up before work, and we'd smoke blunts and shit before I go into work, and we'd just talk and shit. He's a cool motherfucker. He's just got a little bit crazy thoughts about how shit went down, you know? Which, that's fine by me. Yeah. You know, we all gotta have some kind of fucking belief. I don't care what it is.
Oh, yeah. Like, you ever see those black Hebrews? They downtown? Ethiopians? And they, not the Ethiopians, but, okay, there's... this is gonna sound fucked up. They're regular Negroes. They're regular American Negroes, right? Who have decided that they are the lost tribe of Israel, and they're kind of like the Mormon version of.
They're like
it's like almost.
They're like the Black Panthers of Judaism or something.
It's like the Mormon version, like what a Mormon is to a Christian.
Yeah,
these people are like that for Mormon. you know, like
so they are a newfound.
Wait, how do I say?
Aloha, my brother.
Yeah, they're like the Jews version of the Mormons. Yeah, it's like
Happy Hanukkah, like, my nigga.
Yeah. Nah, but they're like, nah. See, we are the lost tribe of Israel, and they do all this marching and shit. And they wear like purple and gold, and it's
we about
it's
to like, stomp the yard.
All right, look, I'm just gonna say it, man. Look, I'm gonna sound like an old white man, but I'm gonna say it right.
Here we go.
Name but some, nothing but some nigga Jews, man. That's all they are, man. I'm sorry, man. Like, when I see them, I just look, I'm like, oh, it's just the nigga Jews. Nobody cares about nigga Jews.
If anything,
you know why they don't care about nigga Jews? Because they're niggers. And nobody cares about niggers. Oh,
that's fucked up. Dude, imagine if Hillary
was. But that's how I feel.
I don't know, man. I got like, really close friends of my family that I've like grown up with that are Ethiopian Jews, and you know, they are black Jews.
Yeah,
but
no, Ethiopians. There's a lot of Jewish Ethiopians. Ethiopia is mentioned a lot in the Bible. It's a big part, even like the New Testament and everything. But those Negro Jews, they're not real Negroes. Those are Ethiopians. I'm talking about niggas, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It reminds me of that joke, you know, the guys are sitting in the restaurant, and they're talking to them, you know, and they're like, you know, you think there's any Chinese Jews? You know, they're sitting in a Chinese restaurant, and he's like, I don't know, let's ask the guy, and calls the waiter over, and he's like, hey. He's like, yeah, and he's like, you guys got any Chinese Jews? He's like, hold on. He goes and walks back to the back and comes back about 5 minutes later, he's like, well, no. Sorry, we got orange juice, apple juice, grape juice.
No Chinese juice.
That is awesome. So what's it like to be Jewish, man? Now that's how
my mother is very interesting.
That's how white people do us. Like, what's it like to be black? So now's my turn to turn the tables a little bit.
I don't know. I'm an interesting little mutt, I guess you could say, because I am German, I'm Cherokee, and I'm Jewish. So,
So
holidays are interesting, let's say that, because my mom, she's traditional. She still likes to do all the traditional holidays.
So y'all do Passover and all the good stuff.
Yes, she does Passover. She does.
Next time that happens, holler at your boy. I want some gefilte fish.
Some gefilte fish.
That shit is amazing.
My mom makes amazing challah bread. But like tonight, she lit the Shabbat candles and... But yeah, it's interesting. It's a mixture because, like, we still.
She kind of likes me. She probably let me come over.
I mean, she still lights all the Hanukkah candles, but we still do Christmas.
You know what?
So you're kind of like almost a new wave because you're still traditional, but you still kind of, you know, are new wave enough to be like, oh, we can do Christmas too, you know?
Yeah.
Well, that's cool though. Hanukkah and Christmas, can't beat that.
But
well,
you know what though, man? I got to say something. You know what? It's like you get the pass. Like, if you want to say nigga, go ahead, man. Because, like, you come from a very oppressed line as well. German Jews. So, like, if you had been there during,
yeah.
No, during actually, World War II.
My mom still has the little jar of sand that my great-grandparents brought from Auschwitz.
Wow. See, okay. Wow. So, and then you're Cherokee as well?
Yeah. And I actually have a registered card and everything else. And that's how you get free health care, is through registered Native American.
You've got the same... You got the same enemy that niggas got, man.
Oh, I know.
It's some other...
Trust me, man.
White people done some fucked up shit to you, too. And you see...
Whenever I get locked up, dude, it's a fight. I already know. Because whenever I get locked up, dude, I got my shit tatted all over my shit, dude. I got stars. I got Hebrew. I got the whole bang all over me.
That's what's up, man.
So I already know.
That's what's up, man.
But yeah, no, it's been an interesting life.
I bet, man.
He's the Hebrew hammer.
Wow. That's very interesting. I like it when you meet people.
Dude, Ben's a badass motherfucker from day one. It's already too late. I just dropped your name.
Yep.
Sorry, Diablo Blanco. Yeah, well, we'll just stay away from certain stories.
No, no woman beating stories.
Well, you just gave yourself away. Might as well tell them now. Look, you're a name dropper, but I may be a name dropper, but you just totally straight up told on yourself. Like, but anyway... Off subject.
The dark episode.
The dark episode. Dun, dun, dun. Sometimes rape is funny. Dun, dun, dun.
Yes, it is. Sometimes rape is funny. And you know what else is sometimes funny? What? Punting a baby through a waterfall.
Yes. And sometimes it's necessary, we found out. Yeah.
Yeah.
We shouldn't go through it because that'll be like the fourth podcast somehow we've gone through it. But Ben, there's definitely a time and a place when it's totally appropriate to put a baby into some water.
I mean, I guess if the baby was on fire, you know what I'm saying?
This guy.
All right.
This guy.
Yep, see.
That's great, exactly great what we got to. That's great. The point we came to. You're going to do fine here, Ben.
Yes.
Great minds think alike.
That's
see?
True.
See? So, see, things can happen. Diversity can happen. You got a ginger. You got... I'm half Irish, half black. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And the Irish are the niggas of Europe.
Oh, no, dude. They were treated like shit their entire fucking existence by the Europeans and the British.
That's what people would tell me. You're half white, so that means half... I was like, no. Half Irish, motherfucker. That means I'm doubly oppressed here.
Yeah. Fuck off.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, see, we got so much in common there, you know. And then you're a ginger, so you got, you know, that's bad enough, man.
You know the funny thing? You know what I love about being a half ginger, though, and being as white looking as I am, is because I found out recently that I'm not only blacker than you, but I'm more Mexican than your wife. That's fucking awesome. That's achievements. Look, you don't get it because you weren't born like 100% white. But when you're born 100% white and you're poor.
I was raised by white people.
Listen, though, but you're poor and you grew up.
I'm a product of the white people, man.
Okay, let me finish. Then you're being kind of black right now and interrupting.
Like, sometimes you gotta let those niggas know their place. You eyeballing me, boy?
Give me a comb, bro.
No, but.
Going yonder.
See, I forgot what I was even saying. You freaking interrupted me. And then I made a joke, and then we all laughed. And then I coughed really hard, and I forgot.
I mean...
Background noise, Friday night.
Good night. It's a perfect time to do a plug. No, but I remember what I was saying. But just for real though, seriously, like kind of joking, but kind of serious. Like growing up being white and poor and not racist at all, and having parents that didn't plant that shit in your mind in any kind of way, you know. And half the kids you played on your street definitely were not white. You know, one thing that you always took pride in was not being a white person. Like, where they're like when. Oh, pause for the cause. It's gonna get darker, not lighter. The world's gonna end.
Did you? Why is the world gonna end?
Huh? Cause of D Malone.
That's not what I heard a minute ago. What I heard rhymed with triggers.
I think he said niggas.
See there? He's always talking about it's me bringing that up and doing that kind of shit, but look at him.
Whoa. Before you hit record and sabotage me, we were...
Ooh.
You.
You knew we were going to do this.
But we were talking, and the
you
joke...
You said Zig Heil, and then you started yelling something about
no, niggas. We were talking about the world ending, and I said, well, if the way D would see it... It was like this, and then so I explained it.
I think Drew's an anti-Semite.
You really think so?
Maybe.
I am. I'm not gonna lie. I am.
But two of my really good friends, like one's black, the other one's Jewish. Like I'm like the perfect. Is it like the perfect cover up?
You're just like all white liberals. You know what I'm saying? Just always. Oh.
If you're not a white liberal mom, I don't listen to you.
Cause
That makes a lot of sense, Drew.
No.
Nah, yeah, you're pretty racist, man.
But my last girlfriend was black.
Exactly. Prove my point right there. And felt like you was fucking a slave.
And you're, and you're my friend. And
actually,
and
the last little black chick he was fucking around with lives on Lake Dallas, and she's actually pretty rich, so you know what I'm saying? Tables have
Lake
turned.
Lake Dallas, huh?
That was recent.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Did you tell about how you... tried to kill a chick out Lake Dallas.
Do you take it out to the wood pile?
No, actually, she got mad because I lied and said Ben was my brother in town from California. She had a homegirl that she could invite over so he could come over with me out there, you know?
He tried to throw a pregnant chick my way.
Yeah, she totally did.
A pregnant chick?
Yeah.
I mean, you was trying to throw her at me.
No, well, I mean, it was there. I mean, she offered, so I offered. It wasn't like I made, but when he was like, no, it's not like I went and left Ben there,
what's
dude.
Wrong?
I turned her down and did my thing. Dude,
no.
What was wrong was is the girl was like 20, 21, pregnant. Like, hey, that's damage.
No, the problem was she was like six months pregnant.
Ugh.
You can't do no more damage.
Yeah, but see, it's, well. It's, I don't know, to me it's a little bit weirder when it's, when it's not
you
yours.
Can.
When it's not yours though, it's a little bit weirder. And
that's
it's
what
like,
makes it even more special.
But no, because there's always that fear that all guys know, and I know Ben's gonna agree with me right now, and it's probably what went through his head is as soon as he banged her, she's gonna be like, oh, you're gonna take care of my baby. We're gonna be so happy together.
No. Not this mother.
Nah, she knows what time it is.
You would think. You would think. But, you know, people shock you. People surprise you every day, motherfucker.
I'm like, no, we're gonna bust these nuts and I'm gonna leave.
No, she's gonna be like, oh. No, my baby felt you. We're attached now. We're a family.
The baby felt me.
My babies went swimming past your baby.
It was
my
actually.
My babies are beating your babies up.
It was actually good that he said no, because she ended up kind of flipping out when I told her, like, oh, I'll come see you Sunday. Like, you know, my brother's in town, you know, I'll go hang out with him. So, of course, she was like, oh, you go find some little hoes. Ooh, boo, 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 boo. And I was like, hey.
And it was a black chick?
Yeah.
Are you a pregnant black chick?
No. I don't think her friend that was black. I think her friend was Mexican or something.
Figure.
No, you better be careful, man, because she can get pregnant again.
Double
pregnant.
Yeah, I heard about that. Like rabbits.
Double pregnant.
I always said Mexicans are like gremlins. Look, man, don't feed them at night and don't get them wet, okay? Because if you do, it's going to be 50 more of
them. Yes.
I love them, though.
Yeah, hey, they are the taco beneath our wings, man.
Dude, I love how conversations get started. Like this all started because you clipped in on me trying to make me seem racist, which is hilarious because it doesn't matter as many times as we've said racist shit on this show. And we're such a versatile mixed group. Like, it really doesn't matter. Like, if anybody wants to bash any race, like, we got it covered. Like, yeah. We got someone to talk shit right yeah. back to you that's the same race, bitch.
Yeah.
So I love it. I love it, guys. That's what it says.
I like how racial slurs, how, you know, you can call me a cracker and you won't offend me. You know what I'm saying?
That's like a compliment, though.
Yeah, yeah, but
I mean,
it is.
But if you call me a kike, I'm probably going to kick your ass.
So that's like y'all's nigger?
Oh, yeah.
I always think about Porky's when I hear the word kike. How that guy in the locker room, he didn't know how to say it right, and he was trying to make that Jewish kid mad. He's like, I think I'm going to go fly a kite. Like, and he was saying kite, and then like the guy walks over to him, like, punches the shit out of him. He's like, it's kike, you dumbass.
Oh, so, okay, well. But see, you got to embrace that shit.
You know, I'm not going to lie. I got a friend, Alan, and I think you know him. You know Alan?
Maybe.
Maybe. But he, you know, we always used to give each other a hard time, you know, and, you know, he used to call me Jew, and I call him Jew, and then, like, it kind of developed into, like, this text war would be like, hey, Julia Roberts, and he'd be like, hey, Aunt Jew Johnson, I'd be like, whatever, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, like, and the funny thing is that it got so out of control that I ended up, looking up his last name, and it turned out that his last name was a German Jewish last name. Like it was a Hebrew, like.
Was it like German Goldstein or something?
Well, I'm not gonna say it just in case it doesn't have his like name dropped like that.
Finkelstein.
But it was something that was hilariously, obviously, you know, German Jewish, and when you look up the last name, it's like, that's the origins. And so he was just like, you know, when I said that, he's like, oh, well, good, now I can use the word kike. And he was like, good job, Kike Tyson. So I was like, oh, shit. So he got me back, so I had to think of something back, so I said him Kikel Jackson.
Oh, man. Yeah, nah, yeah, man, just embrace it, man. I'm telling you. Like, I've liberated myself with the word nigga, man.
I understand, dude. Because people used white to call sucks. Me, you know what I'm saying? How I got the name Ben Jew is people used to pick on me with it. And they used to be like, oh, you know, that's Ben Jew. And then eventually I just got, you know, older and pissed off and tired. And I just started beating the shit out of people for it. And just kind of...
Now you owned it. Yeah. Because you know what? Honestly, I'm not going to lie. I couldn't imagine calling you anything else. And I hope that you don't mind because I've always known you as Ben Jew. You were introduced to me.
I mean, when
me
I was little,
Jew.
Dude, I mind. It bugged the shit out of me, but, you know...
So no. Were people?
I think it's a cool nickname.
Were people like? So you're from? Are you from Texas? And
yeah, no, I'm from Austin, but I moved up here in I moved up here in what was it like 98?
Okay, so Austin, so it's still Texas. So what was the experience like? Because like you hear about like you know the Jewish family. You know what I'm saying? I don't. No many, but I sympathize, you know, like.
Well, I mean, in all honesty, dude, I mean, in Austin, I really wouldn't let outside that much because we lived in the ghetto. But whenever I moved up here, man, I don't know. Yeah, I definitely got picked on a lot.
Wow.
Background noise, Friday nights.
But, no, dude, it was definitely, I didn't like it that much. But I don't know. I eventually just stopped giving a shit.
I feel you, man. Because I got thrown in here with these white Christians, too, man. I feel you, man.
Yeah. No, eventually, so we got I just grew up saying fuck the world.
Yeah, I'm telling you. It sucks being white. Thought. You know, everyone fucking hates you. Like, everyone expects you to be either really rich, really smart, or fucking can't fight. Like... Like, it sucks. Like, being white is, like, the worst thing ever. Like, you can go anywhere on the planet, and they're like, what are you, white? Patooey. Like, welcome.
Piece of shit.
What do you do? Fuck your fat wife and complain about your cable bill? Patooey. White people.
That's kind of America right there.
Yeah,
but even the people that are here, see, but that's the fucked up part about America, and what makes it so great is the people that are talking that shit are living here in America with you.
Yeah,
I didn't go to a foreign country and they're like, fuck you. They're like, here, like, fuck you, whitey. Why the fuck you come here? Like that, like the other day.
Okay, black people, were kind of
broad. Okay, no, I'm not talking about black people. Actually, I'm kind of stealing.
And his people, the Cherokee, they were kind of already here.
Threw a curveball there. I like it.
Fuck you.
How come to you? But
and no, y'all kind of like just came along
and said like, fucked everything up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
y'all
but agree? I'm talking about
it's like me just moving to your house and be like, all right, bitch, this house gonna go.
Yeah, but it's
and like I'm making y'all sleep like under the fucking sink and shit in the kitchen. Like, no, bitch, you better not come out. You make any fucking noise, all you can eat is the coffee grounds I throw away, motherfucker. That's pretty much what they did. That's pretty much what the white man, the Europeans, did
to everybody,
to the natives.
Yeah.
And then, like, the niggas, they just brought them in, did the same shit, and fucked them.
Well, yeah, but, you know, the natives fucked the natives, too, because there were certain tribes that were more advanced.
Well, the Africans fucked the Africans.
Well, yeah, but there were some more advanced tribes that were selling them right to the Belgian the ship traders. Yeah. They were just like, hey, guess what? We're on to what you guys are doing. We don't want to get fucked with, so look, we caught these guys for you. You know, yo, we can trade up, get some shit, you know. Give me some of that fire water, you know?
And eventually hostile takeover.
Exactly. But what I was getting to, I was talking more of Mexican, because I see it a lot here, especially being around Irving and Dallas and stuff, is you see a lot of them that have the attitude that it's like, fuck America. Like, it's all about Mexico. Like, seriously, fuck white people, fuck this culture and everything. But it's like, but you're here. You're living here and not there in Mexico.
Yeah.
Like, I totally am cool with you coming over and being like, I still want to keep my culture. I want to keep my language. I want to keep everything that was a part of my life still here, but just live here and try to function in this society. I'm fine with that. Yeah. But don't come over here with your middle fingers up. Like, we hate y'all. We hate you white people. Like, you know what? You may hate us. And it may be a fucked up situation, but our fucked up situation is obviously a lot better than yours because you came here. So just, why don't you just be like, hey, fuck you because I met you and I don't like you, instead of just saying, hey, I see that ginger beard over there. Fuck that white guy.
But at the same time, I look at it like this. I don't know why we even have borders. I don't know why we have to be restricted in going to other places, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The whole structure is fucking retarded.
Money.
Because people are people.
Money.
People are people, and nobody. When you're born, it's just you, butthole naked, at your mama's pussy or out of stomach. However they got you out. That's it. That's all you own, is that. Nothing else. Everything else is like, it's like a. It's a placebo, really, that we placed on ourselves. And the weirdest part is that the thing that really drives it is just pieces of paper. You know, and they, you know, they're supposed to be worth their weight in gold, but they're not.
They're backed up by nothing.
So somebody takes all the gold, and paper means nothing. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, nobody owns anything. It's not. I don't. I think it's I think it's stupid.
You say to they be, don't, but they do.
But I think it's stupid to be like, "Oh, America's the best," or you know, white is right. Black, you know, black is the best. You know,
you
or
can't.
Like,
you can't, because there's too many different people with too many different opinions on the subject. Your happiness is somebody else's fucking sorrow. Like, nobody's always gonna fully agree what you like. So there's no way anyone can claim that somewhere is the best. You just can't.
Right.
Because there's going to be a million motherfuckers that are going to be like, no, here's the best. And then there's going to be a million more that are like, fuck both of you. It's all about this over here. Like, you know.
Well, it's kind of like,
the best is what you consider. Like, it's whatever you consider, that's the best. Because it's really, at the end of the day, it's your personal, by yourself, your fucking opinion. It's the best.
And that's because, and I believe that is why, like, apocalyptic type of movies or literature and things of that nature so fascinating to everybody. Because when the breakdown, when the cash means nothing, when the car means, well, okay, the car is useful.
To an extent, but they won't be forever.
Right. But like the cash is gonna be the first thing that's like worth nothing. The coins, this paper, the plastic.
You know you're still going to hold some receipts, just in case, though. You know you
and
are.
The insurance papers, you know, and all that shit. Does it mean anything?
I would love to hit the reset button, man. That would be amazing.
You say that, but the only reason why I wouldn't want to hit the reset button is the simple fact of modern medicine. It can do things that you just can't naturally do, you know, out in the gridless system, you know.
But there are things that they're keeping from us that would be very beneficial. And the only reason they keep it from us is because they want more of that paper and plastic. Mm-hmm. And
it's a power trip. It's all power trip. It's all greed at the end of the day. Mankind is going to destroy itself by its own greed and its own consumption.
So I guess what you're suggesting is that we start a background noise commune in the mountains.
No.
Look, hear me out. Hear me out. All right, we grow the sticky plants. We make the sticky punch. We have naked orgies. You know, play a lot of banjos.
We get shot by hillbillies with AKs.
Yeah, no shit. Real quick. Real quick.
2015, this ain't no shotgun. Nah, they'd be coming down there and be like, hey, you got any of that purple sticky moonshine?
Nah, they'd be like, hey, you got a pretty mouth, boy.
I'd be like, you got $1 million?
So imagine if you can't get to your perfect utopian society. Let's say it actually happens, right? This is bound to happen at some point.
Right.
Somebody's going to accidentally find or hit one of those buttons, one of those nuclear bombs, and it's going to trigger all the other ones to come back alive. And it's just going to be a nuclear holocaust at the ultimate end. That's it.
I'd be okay with that.
See, I am too. But see, a lot of other... See, like, you tell him something. I think he's already thinking about going to Mars.
Well, no. See, I think what it is...
We're like, why are we going to go fuck up Mars? What did Mars do to us?
What it is I think it would be for the simple fact of if I didn't have a kid, I wouldn't give a shit. I have a kid, so I got to fucking watch him suffer while I die. Like, that's what I don't want.
No, nuclear holocaust, everybody dies at the same time.
Yeah, everybody goes.
Oh, just instantaneously?
Yeah.
Because the way, you know how the nukes work, right?
To an extent, but I figured I figured it would blow out a good portion of the Earth, but there were some people that would definitely survive the explosion but then die later on from radioactive activity.
No, the fucked up thing is that, okay, let's say they launched a nuke right now and it was headed towards Dallas, per se, right?
America would launch 20 nukes?
Right, back at those people. And then other people's friends, everybody's thing is censored to go off. If the other guy's thing goes off, yours is going to go off. And everybody's that, it's like,
for lack of a better term, it is a big-ass Mexican standoff
going on in the world. That's what I was about to say. Like, they're all just pointing their nukes at each other. Like
the world is...
Holocaust. Nuclear. Holocaust.
And seeing everybody... But everybody's crying because, like, North Korea... Oh my God, North Korea has a missile. Like, ooh, they have a missile. We have, like, how many fucking thousands, you know?
Shit, not how poor they are. It's just got rat poison in it. It's going to explode. Like, rat pebbles are just going to rain down. Like, and then you're going to hear, like, on a speaker, like, eat some. It's good. They're all over there, like, giggling back in North Korea, just like,
And then, okay, now, goddamn, man, we got political officer. All right, look. So, Iran. Did y'all hear about this thing that's going on?
Iran's with so far
with their nuclear power plant and all that shit.
Okay, so Iran, I don't know all the complete full details. All I know is that Barack Obama is trying to negotiate with Iran over nuclear power. They don't necessarily have a bomb, but they have nuclear. But there's a possibility they could get it, right?
What Iran is doing right
now. But they're not going to do it.
No, they're trying. I don't know. It's. Who really fucking knows the details and shit? You know what I'm saying?
If anybody could do it, they'd have done it by now.
I mean, they might have already done it. No. All I know is they have a nuclear development plan, supposedly.
They and can't even grow grass. Like, fuck these guys.
Thank you.
Dude.
It's like being scared of the kid in the neighborhood who only has a pellet gun.
It's not that, you know, they can't do it or they're too dumb. It's where they live. It's lack of fucking resource.
They're not going to do it.
They have oil.
They've got oil. Ooh, we can go in there and fuck up their whole lives and take their oil.
They have Russia backing them up.
We don't trade with
really? Them. They got Russia backing them up? Russia scares me.
Why?
Dude, could you imagine?
Look, man, I ain't gonna lie.
Look, Russia.
Vladimir Putin, he's a fucked up dude, but he's kind of a badass. Like,
because, yeah, but
because. Okay, I'm sorry.
Russians are hardcore.
Barry's all right. He might be able to do a little singing and stepping and dancing and fetching and, you know, doing Negro, playing little basketball and shit. Man, Vladimir Putin would fuck Obama up, man. You put them in the cage together, man. Rear naked chokehold, 10 seconds, man. Yeah, motherfucker be out.
But that's how Russians
Vladimir
are.
Vladimir Putin, nigga. That is like the Chuck Norris to fucking Russians, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm sorry, that's a bad motherfucker,
dude,
man.
Dude, all Russians are. Normal Russian citizens are 10 times more badass than the most combat-trained American. Dude, you see their videos when they get bored? Those motherfuckers climb buildings without any ropes or anything and then hang out on the ledge. Normal yeah, dude, fucking I've
actually,
day.
I've actually seen some pretty crazy.
Let's just jump videos. Train from train yeah. and fucking drink vodka and fucking beat the shit out of people, shoot drugs that rot our bodies from the inside out.
Oppression
like.
And,
exactly. Yeah. So imagine if you give this motherfucker some sort of controlled training and a fucking weapon. Are you kidding me? Even if America won, it'd be one of those fights where it's like literally like one person's left in the army and he's just like all fucked up, like missing arm, like we did it, America.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. And like and even the bodies of the Russians don't even look that bad. Like it's just like
You know what I would love to know more about? Chernobyl.
Yeah. Man, yeah.
I mean, because, you know, that's an entire city, dude, just left,
disappeared.
And then that motherfucker's like, how they say it is inhabitable.
Supposedly.
Did I say it right? Yes. Say inhabitable.
Yes.
Okay, it's like I got it right. What is it, like the radioactive
for 10,000 years. For 10,000 years.
It's like the radioactive levels, yes. Right? But didn't you hear the stories about the wolves? Dude, no. There's people that have actually gone there. Like, literally gone there in suits and shit and walked around and recorded and took pictures and shit. Found out that there's species of animals still living and thriving in that area. And there's a species of wolf there. Well, I mean, it's not like a new species or anything, but that particular wolves that are living in that area are bigger than normal.
That's awesome. I think...
That's not awesome. It's going to turn into something like from Ninja Turtles. Yeah, like, Tolkarazar!
That's epic to me, dude. But I think that there's probably a lot more going on there than what we know. You know what I'm saying? Because that's an entire fucking, you know, city. Damn near, you know what I'm saying? It might be like a state.
What kind of testing did they do?
It was a nuclear facility that had a meltdown. A nuclear power plant had a meltdown. You know what I'm saying? And killed a fuckload of people. But I don't know if it's the size of a city or I don't know if it's the size of a state.
Not Chernobyl. Well, it was like a huge like military like town.
Yeah, because it probably wouldn't be as big as like a city, because like
dude, I know. I've seen some pictures, dude. It looks pretty humongous. I mean, really? It all looks like overgrown, and you know what I'm saying.
I would say crazy. I would say it's probably like it was like a small town, like it wasn't like say as big as like say Dallas. Or anything like that.
They definitely had big buildings.
Well, it was a smaller community. But it was still, it was like big enough to say be like, say like Forney or something, or tell like a not like a two stop town, but you know what I'm saying, like one that's kind of thriving. It's kind of maybe like a McKinney or some shit like yeah. that. You know what I'm saying? And it was, but either way it goes, they had to. Everybody was gone.
It's a ghost.
10,000 years. They said it's going to be inhabitable for like over 10,000 years. That's if we're lucky.
I said, let's take a road trip.
How? What I don't understand is
how. And they tested this shit here.
What do you mean you take a road trip, go out there and get some kind of poisoning?
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Stock up on some suits, whatnot.
We're not going to get any superpowers if we go roll around in the toxic, okay?
Man, you blow my hopes and dreams out of the water.
The closest I'll do is I'll go like to Roswell or something. I'm like. Wherever, you know, like in
New Mexico.
Yeah, you know, like where they did a little testing out there and look at it from a distance. Like,
just sit in a bush.
Looking for you. I had to sit there with some binoculars. Like, man, it sure is dark over there.
Well, let's go, guys.
Yep. But yeah, would you hit the button?
No.
No?
Nah, nothing to do with pussy. I don't want to die.
You don't have...
I wouldn't hit the button unless I wanted to die. It's that simple. I don't... Not in this state of mind, the way I feel right now, on this point in life, do I want to hit the button.
You wouldn't do it, just say, man, you know what, fuck y'all.
Depends. It depends on what happened to me that led me to that point to push that button. I mean, there's always a situation where I'm going to push that fucking button, but there's always a situation where I'm not.
Tell us about it, Drew. What happened to you?
Who pushed that button?
He pushed it a lot.
Did he push the button too far, Drew?
He gave me candy. Told me it was okay because he was a man of God.
Was he Catholic, Drew?
He gave me molasses balls. Treated me to some cunnilingus. Then he fellatiated me for an hour.
Oh, man,
fellatios.
Well, when I was a younger lad, during the springtime, we'd go down there to the yonder parts, and a fine young lady would come in her Sunday dress, and I'd say, how's about a little fellatiation? And she said, only if you give me a bit of cunnilingus. And so to top it off, we both did a little analingus.
I'm telling you, D, we need to make that like a fucking sketch. We need to have a guy dress up like Colonel Sanders and fucking talk like that and tell the stories.
Have his little hand fan.
Yeah. Oh, this flower is wilting. Just like, my favorite one was when you talked about the Shaded Grove. It's like,
The Shaded Grove.
It's like, I remember when we were quite a younger lad, striking young lads, we would go down to the Shaded Groves when it was hot, and there would be an older gentleman caller that would hand us balls of molasses in exchange for fellatiation.
I said, how's about a little bottle of molasses and we get a little fellatiation? And I says, I say, only if I can get a little cunnilingus.
He said, it's bad for your teeth, but in this industry, teeth might be bad for you. So eat the molasses and keep working.
And she said, my dear sir, I have a husband. Like, yes, but he's just an ordinary piss faggot. And nobody wants to get with a piss faggot. Because Drew's a piss faggot for texting on his phone in the middle of a podcast.
Dude, someone is watching my child right now.
You're sexting right now. Shit.
I'm definitely not sexting.
Don't lie, that was porn.
You know, if I'm sexting, I admit that I'm sexting, and we giggle about it and talk about it for a minute. But nope, that was.
And you'll say your name on the thing.
Sometimes.
Like, That's right. Julie KS. That's right. You said, hey, do I want to give you some cunnilingus? I said, hell no, bitch, but you give me some fellatiation, we can make this thing happen.
Bitch.
Guess what? She sent me a picture of her underwear. That's about as far as it
goes. Dirty.
That would be the biggest turn off ever. Could you imagine that?
Like, drawers. You texting some girl, and you're just like, ooh. She's like, oh yeah, you want me to get dirty? Like, yeah, girl, I want you to be real dirty. You want me to send you something dirty? Shit. Like, yeah, and you just like see dirties with a shit stain. You're like, what the fuck?
But it's got like a hemorrhoid print.
Oh, oh my God.
She was like, and this is a good day. Like, oh, God damn, bitch, you really are dirty.
Still want to hit it?
No.
You're like, I'm not going to lie.
It's like, I'm not going to lie. Hell no. That's disgusting. But I respect you as a person and find you hilarious now and would like to treat you to dinner. Just no sex afterwards until you learn to wipe your ass.
That ain't right.
Hey, she can learn to clean it, you know. Being dirty is not a permanent thing. It's something that can be fixed. And if it can be fixed,
well,
I'll fuck with it. You know, if you have an off day and I'm like, oh, that's fucked up. They're like, oh, sorry, let me go clean up. I'm like, okay, cool.
What if it's like herpes?
can't clean our puppies.
We have an interesting topic about this. Now, if they have herpes down there, Drew will take a blowjob.
I'll take a blowjob. You can't get, if they got herpes down there, they ain't got it in the mouth, then you can suck my dick. Yeah, fuck it.
Taking chances, man.
Dude, life's all about risk.
So you're saying you'll take a herpes blowjob?
Yeah, fuck it, why not? I mean, not if they got it on the mouth, they're lying, you get a shot to the mouth, and you
But what
fucked.
If she just has herpes on her mouth, but not on her cunnilingus area?
No, then I'm not gonna risk it.
What the fuck? Herpes is herpes, man.
Hey, I didn't say I had a logical explanation for this shit. I was just kind of thrown into this bus by a woman beater over here.
I'm just saying.
Sometimes there's a reason to beat a woman, but there's never a reason to fuck a girl who's got herpes on the mouth but not on the pussy.
No, I mean, if a girl was like, hey, we can't fuck, I got herpes, but I'll give you a blowjob, really, you're just going to be like, no.
Yeah.
No, whatever. You say that herpes, now because you're married.
Nah, man, because it's herpes, man.
Nah, in her mouth. She doesn't have it in her mouth.
Whatever, man. It's on the same body, man.
Well, I'm the same guy that'll fucking suck a dick for $1 million, you know? I'm just different from y'all.
Okay. Would you fuck a bitch with herpes? And I'm talking about during the outbreak.
Like actual fucking sex with a girl with herpes.
While she's having flares.
While it's broken out.
Like yeah, like pounded out.
Uh-huh.
$1 million.
Why not?
Because.
But you'll suck a dick.
Yeah, because. Oh, yeah. Because after I suck that dick, I'm not gonna break out into sores every few fucking months and have to take medication the rest of my life. So, no, I wouldn't fuck a girl with herpes and her vagina.
What about for $10 million?
No. I don't know. Because the way the fucking.
But it's not the end of your life.
It's not. And you can always find somebody with herpes. I get it. But it's the sores are painful.
But you can't catch herpes from them all the time.
Yeah.
It's the crazy
part. Only during outbreaks.
Yeah.
And also, I heard that you can also, you know what I'm saying, you can possibly only have a couple outbreaks throughout your entire life.
Weird.
Or you could get fucked and you could have outbreaks all the damn time.
All the fucking time. Well, I'm sure there's a lot of medications for that shit.
Okay, would you put a dental down?
A what?
You know those dental
would
down
you
thing?
Eat a girl out with herpes?
Hell with no!
With, but she got the thing
like
on there.
It's like a window of protection for your face.
Yeah.
A window of protection?
Yeah, yeah. It's like...
It depends. I would need to know. I would need to know the safety ratio of this particular product and the success rate of this particular product.
It's like saran wrap, homie.
But it's like medical saran wrap.
Yeah.
So it's like super strong.
It's like the condom for the tongue, man.
Yeah. That's exactly go down what it is.
For how much?
Okay. Here we get interesting. A homeless woman.
No.
That was unanimous. We all know what that's about.
And the crazy part is like, not even like, oh, is it a homeless woman with, you know, herpes, one with AIDS, you know?
No,
it's like a homeless woman. No, just flat out no, period.
Well, I mean, I heard bum bumps are worse than herpes, so.
Yeah?
What?
Bum bumps? You never heard of a bum bump?
Never heard of a bum bump.
You need to get out more.
No, apparently I don't. I might get bum bumps.
But you know what's worse than herpes?
What?
AIDS.
Nigger herpes.
Nerpes?
Are they black herpes?
No, they're just nigger herpes.
They don't ever leave. They just hang around. Fucking eat up all your food.
They never leave and they fuck shit up.
And they fuck your wife when you're not looking.
Yeah, you want to hear a good racist joke?
Sure.
What do niggers?
I still have a hard time. Even though you're black, it's like you kind of can say it. It's like
what do niggers and tornadoes have in common?
I don't want to answer this one.
I'm trying to think.
It's pretty simple.
Go ahead.
It only takes one to fuck up an entire neighborhood.
Oh, damn it. I didn't even think it was that bad. Well, racist jokes, huh?
Oh, we all know them.
But that's the only one I know.
No, you're bullshit.
Damn.
Bullshit. Damn. Dude, half the time you invent at least 8 new racist jokes when I'm hanging around you. Like, I'm just like, well, that's a new one. That just got out into the universe. Like,
yeah. I love white people though, man.
I think my favorite racist joke is the kid who dumps the flour. The black kid that dumps flour on himself.
What?
Yeah, yeah, it's this little black kid after dinner goes in the kitchen, takes flour and starts dumping it on himself, and his grandma sees him and says, "Boy, what are you doing?" And he says, "Grandma, I just want to be white." So she whoops his ass, goes, "Go tell your mom what you just said." So he walks over there covered in flour. She's like, "Well, why are you covered in flour?" He said, "Mom, I was just trying to tell grandma I wanted to be white." So she beats his ass, says, "Boy, go tell your father what you just said." So he goes over to his father. His dad, you know, just got home from work. He's tired. He's sitting on the couch. He's like, what are you getting them women riled up for?" He said, "Dad, I was just trying to explain to him I want to be white." He looked at him all shocked, whooped his ass, said, "Boy, go to your room." So the little kid goes upstairs, goes to his room, slams the door, crosses his arms, says, "Oh, I've only been white for 5 minutes. I already hate them niggers."
It's like the ultimate Uncle Ruckus.
Yeah. Uncle Ruckus, that's a crazy motherfucker, I'll tell you that much.
I think he's one of the funniest characters.
Who invented... Yes. That's what... See,
Aaron Magruder.
We need to bring the laptop back in the mix when we do this shit, for real.
Yeah, that was Aaron Magruder. He did... The Boondocks, it was a
comic book script. He actually created the character concept of Ruckus, though?
Yeah.
Nice.
He started out as a... he was in college... And he would do comic strips for like the New York Times or something like that.
Yeah. The Boondocks.
Yeah, and I remember that from even when I was still like a teenager.
And then they stopped the strip for about 2 years. They said they were going to bring it back, but then they didn't. They started doing the show.
And these white liberal people had been seeing it, and they liked it. They thought it was cool, and they approached him about making the animated series about it. He's a fucking genius, man. But yeah, Ruckus has been around since the comic strips.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But the dude who does the voice and plays him, that dude is
crazy.
Fucking genius. He was in, you remember Harold and Kumar?
Yeah.
He was remember the black dude in the
jail? Prison, yeah. He was also the dad of the nerdy kid in Malcolm in the Middle.
Man,
the
kid that dude, that
talk like this.
That dude is, like, extremely talented. Like, in the shit he can do, man. And he's just, like, he's, like, real brilliant. He's way underrated for how brilliant he really is. You know what I'm saying?
There's a lot of actors like that.
But Uncle Ruckus, man. I was doing this shit when I was in that play at school. I would just, like, quote Uncle Ruckus the whole time. But I was like...
It's like, you know, when you said that, I don't know, this is the way my weird brain works. I just thought of, like, an 80s style, like, training video. Like, how to make... white people comfortable when you're black, and it's just like Ruckus jokes. It just shows you, like, don't go trusting them niggas around there, and all the white people are like, he's funny.
Do you know how
he gets how we feel?
How I've made it all these years at my job? It's just being the nigga and I go in there.
You work at a firm though, right?
Yeah, law firm.
Nice,
pretty successful one too, man. I go in there and I just talk shit. I talk shit about everybody, right? But I do it in the way I do it, you know what I'm saying? But, like, I make these white people uncomfortable, but they realize that I'm really telling the truth. You know what I'm saying? Or sometimes they get butt hurt and shit, but they don't want to get too mad because they don't, you know, like, you know, it's okay, all right, D, that's it. You know, like, it's never like, you can't say that. That happened one time up there. One time this white bitch going to tell me, because I said, nigga. Up in the conference room, we was all eating and shit. And I was like, I said, son, this is some niggers, you know how I do, niggers, negroes, spooks, yeah. You know, moon crickets, yeah. Whatever.
If
man.
You're around, the N-word's gonna get said at least 16 times.
Yeah, and this white bitch gonna tell me, you can't say that. I said, say what? She's like, you can't say the N-word. I said, I didn't say the N-word. Well, you know what I'm talking about. No, I don't. Man, that is a racist word. What's a racist word? The N-word. You know what you said. I was like, what, need? You know, like, not?
Getting your best to make her say it. I'm going to make you say it.
You can't say that. I said, what, nigga? Yeah, that. You can't say that. I said, oh, okay. Nigga. The fuck you going to do about it? You know what I'm saying? Fuck them. But... She was the only one that ever did that. But I do it. You know, I throw around my nigga jokes pretty, you know, with taste, you know what I'm saying? At the office.
If there's such thing, yes.
And I get away with it. And I get away with saying that thing that everybody's thinking. Or the thing that everybody can't say, right? That
everybody's scared to
say. And I get away with it, dude. And I think that they like it because somebody's actually getting to say it out loud, even though it's not them. Somebody's actually getting to say this shit.
So you can basically just go in there and tell them how you feel, too, just like straight up. Just
yeah,
like, fine. This is how I feel.
I mean, you know, sometimes they want to act a little, you know, uppity and shit.
So you could walk in and be like, sup, Johnson? Hey, Bateman, oh, if your wife gets drunk like she did last Christmas party, I'm a fucker.
Yeah. Like, I say crazy shit. Like, I come in. I basically sound like Joey Diaz half the time. Like, hey, how you doing? Like, ah, well, you know, man, I got fucked up last night. You know, like man, I was eating. I'll fucking throw shit out there. Oh, man. I fucking took a couple bong hits, man. Fucking high shit, man. Like, oh, my God. I was asking myself the age-old question, the Beatles or the Stones? And I said, you know what? I got to go with the Stones. Fuck the Beatles, those little faggots and their little boots and their little bob haircuts. The Stones, they had heart. You know what I'm saying? You know, like, I'm going out, but see, that's how I do it. See, I relate to them on a certain level because a lot of them are, like, you know, early 60s.
Yeah, back 50s, in the day, 40, you know they were smoking yeah. pot and chilling, and so listening like, to the Stones and shit.
And seeing, I listen to all kinds of shit. You seen.
Yeah,
oh, I'm
yeah.
very diverse in what I listen to.
You can tell just by the openings of the podcast.
Yeah, man. And so, I know those questions that they want to know.
Yeah.
I trip out some white people. I was at Six Flags, and it was around Halloween time. And now this is probably about... This is about 7 years ago. But anyway, this is when I really started getting, when I finally just let my walls down and was like, I did not like hip-hop music on the radio. I could not stand it anymore.
Yeah, I got that
one. It had gotten so shitty.
Yeah.
And so, like, I would have to say, because if you pay attention to the type of rap music I listen to, the shit that I listened to it to up until about 2002, 2003-ish, sprinkle of things from 05, that's it. Like, I just don't have any love for this shit no more. Yeah. It's just gotten so contrived that I said, you know what, fuck it. I was like a closet, you know, like rock fan and shit. And I was like, fuck it, I'm too fucking old to care about what people think, you know, norms. And so I started listening to everything. I started grabbing. I remember shit that I listened to as a kid, you know, like from the 1950s, the 60s. I was grabbing any and everything I could think of, man. And, like, so I basically did a whole rock and roll history for myself. You know what I'm saying? I love the shit, you know. But, yeah, that's how I relate to them. So I can just go back and, you know, throw a song out, like, oh, yeah. You know, Hendrix, you know, he was good, you know. But, you know, that Jim Morrison, God, he had some lyrics. You know, like, you know, white people had, oh, yes, you know. I thought he was just going to talk about, like, you know, Prince or something.
Look, we go together because opposites attract. Paul Abdul. See you later.
Yeah, you know. So I know how to schmooze white people, man. You know, like I don't know how to really schmooze cops.
Me neither.
because cops are their own race.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because when I say, because, like, you know, some people say, oh, these white police, I'm the first one to tell you. I don't just hate white police. I hate police.
Yeah, I agree. I don't care if it's that motion. Black cops kill just as much.
Oh, man, fuck a black cop, man. Dude,
black cop throw me on the ground just as quick as a white cop will.
Dude, man, and I'm sorry, but even towards niggas, black cops are worse than white cops, huh? You know what I'm saying? They're like that field hand. They're like, Toby, you better go there and beat old Jerome. He ain't picking his fair share.
Toby.
Because if you don't, I'm going to come down off this horse. I'm going to beat your black ass.
Dude, it's crazy. In TDC, in the Texas prison systems, man, I'll say this. 90% of the guards that work there are African. Are, like, legitimately from Africa.
It's oh, wild. Shit.
Dude, it's my wild.
No way.
Yeah.
Dude, my buddy.
I tell you what, no dude. Way. I shit you not, man. All the prison systems in Texas, they're all passported out of here, man.
Dude.
They're all over here on work visas.
African?
I have backup.
No, you buddy. No.
Hey, yeah, motherfucker. No. You right there. You better get on your bunk right now.
Dude. No, no Aryan shit.
No, Aryan brother bullshit.
Don't bring this shit to my house, motherfucker.
Shit, she not, man. And but guess motherfucker. What? They don't give a fuck, dude. I mean, they don't.
He's legit on that shit. Cause remember recently, I went and saw my buddy Brian, who's been locked up in prison. He's out in a small town in Texas called Tennessee Colony.
Mm-hmm.
Fun story I want to tell about that.
No, that's where they had PMC locked up at.
Really?
Yeah, that's where he did his time.
Well, he's locked up with a couple famous killers out there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's it called?
The Jasper. The Jasper murders.
No! Yeah. The dude who drugged the guy out the truck.
Both of them, they're there.
Really? Those guys?
What prison is he at?
I don't know the name of the prison. I just know it's in Tennessee Colony, which is a town that literally has like four tiny little buildings. And that's it.
And a prison.
But, when we went out there, it's true. Like, all the guards, pretty much African with an accent.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's nuts, man.
And it's weird. They have all the... Dude, they make so much money off those vending machines. You go in there...
Oh, yeah. It's always been like that.
Yeah.
No, that's
and you can, like, new, take man. It out. Well, you know, I haven't visited too many people in prison. I usually just ride
them. Oh, man.
You know?
It's been like that since vending machines were fucking invented, man. Yeah. Like, they've been making and killing... Shit.
People just stand there and low phone calls into that shit.
Vending machine.
Yeah, man. And fucking you have to take it out of the package and put it in a sandwich baggie and then roll it up and then they'll put it like in this thing and then the prisoner can like come get it and you sit between this mesh and like talk to him.
It's not the place to be, man.
Oh, I know.
Oh yeah, he's not exactly in the highest spirits, but I think the worst part about it is he's at the end of his term. So now time feels really slow because he's about a month and a half away from being released. Which,
oh, man.
Which we'll all get time? To meet him.
How long has he been locked up?
About, I think it's like 2 years, 3 years.
That sucks, but like, I've never like been to prison, but I sat in a county for 6 months. And I know it don't seem like shit to a lot of people, but man, that's all it really took for me to realize like, you know what? I don't like being told what to do. That's the only thing I didn't like.
You gonna mind somebody.
Right. But, looking back, like, I'm not gonna lie. Sometimes there's a time like, man, I guess it's because I was in a county facility. Not in a, you know, an actual prison setting, you know. It's like, because there were dudes in there that had been in there for like 5 years.
Yeah.
And I'm like, fuck, how the fuck do you wanna do this for
fighting
5 years?
Fighting cases, dude.
I started thinking about, like, oh, I gotta do it maybe two. That would go fucking nuts, you know? But nah, it's a. But they have Africans.
Yeah.
I'm offended. Fuck that. I'm going on record as a nigga right now. Fuck that. I don't want no fucking Africans running the fucking prison system. Dude, you know what else I don't want?
Because they'd probably be like, this ain't shit, dude.
You know another race I hate? Cab drivers.
Cab drivers.
Yeah, I don't care where they're from. I hate cab drivers. And I hate, what was that thing I said? I hated,
pretty much everybody.
But yeah, I hate cab drivers. Oh, police.
Police and
they're their own race. They're their own race, man.
Cab drivers are their own race, too?
Yes.
I haven't really dealt with really.
You know who I hate?
Cab drivers.
Vegans.
Assholes.
Fucking gay.
They're usually just whiny.
Pussies.
We're kind of whiny right now, too. Yeah. Who cares? Fuck us all. Fuck us all. Right in our balls.
And I'm gonna push the button. Right now.
Would you do it right now? Would you in the world do
it? Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah.
If they're just like, dude. Fuck you, make sure you stay away from any buttons. It's like, we're gonna ask you. No! Not him! You already know the answer with him.
They're like, would you do it right now? No. But I'll do it now.
Click. Dang, that'd be crazy.
Yeah, I'm not the person to ask. I don't think you would, really. I like the Joker from The Dark Knight. Man, I really connected with that guy, man. It's like Alfred said, there's some people that they do it for power, some people that will do this for money, but there's some that just want to see the world burn.
Yep.
Because they were talking about this crazy guy who was stealing all this fucking gold and all this shit.
Not doing anything with it.
Just running around setting fires everywhere. Because all he wanted to do was just destroy everything.
I mean, dude, I think that's kind of like mankind's fault, though, because it's really... I don't know. I see the, like, the new generations and new societies, dude, like, coming out and just basically that's all they want. Because, like, today's generation, that's all these kids want is really just to sit back and watch the world burn. And a lot of them are willing to do it.
Yeah. True that.
They just disguise it as ambition.
Yeah.
And a good life and shit.
Because, I mean, society is increasing on one hand, but on the other end, it is also decreasing and, you know what I'm saying, destroying itself.
True that.
Tits button.
Just hit the button.
Come on.
I'm convinced.
It's a lose-lose game.
I'm convinced.
And look. You know what else is possible? Oh, yeah, we're going to go deep. This is possible. The Terminator.
Dun, dun, dun.
Think so?
Think about it.
Sending a droid back in time to stop
look,
shit.
Look, okay. Now we got droids doing that kind of shit, yep, right?
Artificial intelligence.
And then they got all kinds of robots. They even got, like, those little cats. Those, like, lion and cheetahs or whatever.
I've seen that they can run up to fucking 60 miles an hour, dude. It's like a remote control, basically. Little fucking, like, cheetah that will chase your ass down. It's metal. You know what I'm saying? Metal teeth, metal claws, guns, fucking whatever else.
Stainless steel and shit like
it
that.
It's bulletproof, and it will chase your ass down at 60 miles an hour during whatever kind of terrain and fucking get you. Have y'all seen those fucking
mosquitoes,
dude?
And they can't put weapons on them.
Have you seen those mosquitoes, dude, that they developed? Like, it's a fucking mosquito, right? And it can inject you with a GPS unit. It can take your fucking blood sample, you know what I'm saying, and fucking process everything and send it
back
over.
If it doesn't get swatted.
No, but I'm just saying, dude, it's a mosquito. You know, it has a microphone, video camera, all that shit.
That's scary because, like, okay, you seen my garage, right?
Yeah.
My favorite time to work out is springtime and summertime in this Texas heat.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you get more loose, you know, the heat and everything, and, dude, mosquitoes coming in. And they get me, man.
Now, this is just scary shit, this man. Is just theory, okay? You know all these... This is just an idea that came up. You know all these, like, diseases and shit that came out, like H1N1, swine flu, blah, 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 blah. You know how, like, there's theories out there that say, you know, it's probably the government, this, that, and the third, you know, but it's being transferred by mosquitoes. That is a very possibility, dude, that they could use one of those to inject you.
Yeah, like, the spread the little virus, little virus skeeters.
Yeah.
Virus skeeters.
Chemtrails. Podcast over.
Podcast over. Bruh. Background noise. Friday nights.
Man, you've been a great guest, man.
Appreciate it.
Man, I like this, man.
Friday 13th.
Man, you made us be a little bit more intelligent.
Well, you know.
Believe it or not, I like that, man.
A guy told me one time, an old school dude, surprisingly, he was in jail too. He told me, he said, you can always judge and tell some people by the way that they talked. He said that simple-minded people talked about people. He said average-minded people talked about events. He said, but great-minded thinkers talked about ideas and theories.
That's true.
But whenever you have certain types of people around you, you feed off that energy and, you know what I'm saying, you go from there.
I like this, man.
That's bullshit, nigga. You need to listen to some Nicki Minaj and start acting like Lil Wayne.
He looks before like a gremlin.
Before your whole life gets fucked up, okay? He may have died off the scissor, but, you know, his Texan skills are pretty fast.
Yeah. His slang's pretty wild.
And I just saw on a billboard in Dallas today that Nicki Minaj has a malt liquor now named after her.
Oh, yeah, no, she does. It's a Moscato.
It's a Moscato. Oh,
what's a wine? A wine?
It's a spirit.
So it's a sprit. A spritzer.
It's a sprit.
So basically what you're telling me is some malt-ass fucking liquor.
Nah, it's like shit that even like white
Cold 40 drink. Spritzers.
Nah, like bitches on Dynasty be drinking spritzers and shit like that. Like,
yeah, but now you can get it in a bottle of 6 for $7.99.
Nah, it's
the Minaj shit is expensive.
It's a little higher dollar, man.
She said she ain't no cheap hoe.
Depends on how rich you are, I guess, what cheap
know,
is.
You know what I'm saying?
Because cheap depends on your level of money in your pocket. Because there's someone that's like, oh, $1,500 for that? That's no big deal.
Like, whoa.
Other people be like, $1,500?
Wait, what? You want $50 for this bottle of wine? No. I could buy 50 bottles of Night Train right now.
I will get some Purple Passion from the 90s.
It's a wild Irish rose.
Some old, what is it, Boone's Farm?
Thunderbird, yeah, Boone's Farm. Man,
Boone's Farm. That shit'll tear you up. So, MD-2020, I'll tell you that much.
Man, like, Boone's Farm, that's what you would get when you want to be, like, a so-called romantic.
I made some ham sandwiches and got us some Boone's Farm. And then Mad Dog was when you just wanted to. Mad Dog was when Mad Dog was when you didn't want to buy him any food or anything. You just want him to smoke a little weed and then fuck. And it's like you smoke that joint and then you let her down that bottle of Mad Dog. It's like, okay, it's game time.
Dude, I tell you what, dude. Mad Dog has gotten me the drunkest I've ever been in my life. I drank 6 bottles of that shit one time. Thought I was a badass, right? I was so drunk, I could not open my eyes, but I could not fall asleep. Tell me that works out.
That sounds like you're in your little own little hell there for a minute, like
and constant puking.
Oh, that's the name, Mad Dog.
Dude, recently, I was at my buddy's house, and you know me, I rarely drink, but I decided to drink. You know, it was a special occasion. A bunch of us guys are getting together, and so we're having a good time, putting a few back, and my friend's wife's little brother. I told him, I said, here, I'll give you $10 from the store. Get me some cigarettes. You can keep the change. He said, okay, because, you know, I'd been drinking. And he hadn't. And so he goes, and he's not too young. He's old enough to buy alcohol. You know, I think he's about 21. And he goes and he comes back with a bottle of Mad Dog.
Yeah, he was 13.
And so, like, the blue Mad Dog.
Oh, yeah.
And,
8th grade.
He sets that shit on the table and talks and ends up fucking leaving. Doesn't even take a drink out of it or anything. So this whole bottle of Mad Dog sitting there, and it's just us, me and some friends, and another one of Matt's friends come over, and he's a little bit younger than us, and we're sitting there, and like, we're all old. We've all had our Mad Dog bad times, you know, so we're all kind of looking at it, laughing about it, like, hey, he was like, I'll give you $50 to chug that. And then my other friend was like, dude, if you'll chug it, I'll give you 60. And so it was like going around like that. And then I think it got up to about $75. Like everyone throwing in money. Like whoever wants to chug it, this is the pool going. Like you get it. But you have to drink it in 2 drinks.
My mind's telling me no.
Dude, that young kid was like, he wasn't paying attention to us at first. You know, we were sitting there smoking time. He's just kind of chilling. He's on his phone and shit, you know. And then he fucking pops up and realizes that there's actual money already on the table involved. And he's like, what? Are y'all for real? Like, that money right there on keep? He said, yeah. Fucking grabs that bottle. He's like, fuck you guys. It's my money. We're all like, no, we're just kidding. Like, dude, don't really do it. And he's like, no, if I get to keep that money, like, well, we laid it on the table. Like, he fucking snaps that bottle over and I'm shit you not. Doesn't drink it in 2 drinks. Drinks it in 1. Then he's sitting there and he's like, I'm fine. We're all like, dude, he's fucking, you're gonna suck in about 10 minutes at life. Like, in about 10 minutes, about 15, 20 minutes go by. He's a little drunk, but he's holding it well. And we're all like, we're shocked. We're like, wow, he did pretty good. Like, little soldier and shit. Now, took about 30 minutes in. This motherfucker is sloppy, drunk, talking shit. Forgot about the whole bet. Was just like, I just took y'all's money. Like, y'all don't even know why. And I got this money, like, cash money shit fucking falling all over the place. Some girls come over. He actually makes the girls literally feel so uncomfortable. One of the girls that I was meeting up for the night was like, hey, we're going to leave now. And if you want to come back to my place, you're cool. But we kind of don't want to say anything to anybody. So he doesn't come.
Man, I remember...
But he did it. He drank that shit.
The guy who was my best friend, his dad was kind of like a father figure to me. And these were Choctaw Indians, right? So, man, he was like a big dude, right? Anyway, he was from Oak Cliff, football star, Golden Gloves boxer, you know. Rough, you know, like, you know, straight up, you know, warrior, you know, like... Tough native, right? Man. Anyway, he was a big drinker. He was, of course, you know, the drunk Indian. But tough as nails. Anyway, we're shooting pool one night, right? And it's me, him, and his son. We're drunk as hell. And we're at a bowling alley in Arlington. And he's bent over to take a shot, and other people are buying, you know, getting tables to play on. So he pulls the stick back like real far. And this girl's walking by. It's these hot young girls right there, these white girls. And he almost hits one of them in the mouth. And she backs up. She's like, oh. I was like, hey. You almost hit that girl in the mouth, man. He's like, oh. And, like, you got to realize we've drank three tall St. Ives malt liquor drinks. Then we drank a fifth of Kentucky Deluxe. Fucking corn liquor, you know. And we've been drinking Wild Irish Rose. And we're smoking a little weed. So, like, we're going, you know, balls deep, right? So he almost hits the girl in the mouth. And so I was like, oh, man, you almost hit her mouth. So he goes over there. And he's like, he's doing that famous Indian stare when they're drunk. Like, they're not staring at you. They're staring through you.
Yeah.
You know, like, you could tell that their pupils and all that, they're not really linking up with everything. But, like, they're seeing on this different level. And he looks at the girl and goes, hey, I'm going to tell you like I tell these boys. You keep your mouth shut, you won't get nothing put in it, okay?
Oh, that's good shit.
Now look, I'm like, ha ha ha. I start laughing so hard, dude. I'm sitting on there's the ramp, right, for the handicaps.
Yeah.
To come down, so I'm sitting up on the rail. I start like, ha 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 ha. Fucking let go and fall off the thing. And, Instead of the girls getting mad and like slapping, like, oh, you fucking pervert or whatever, they're like, oh, he's so cute. I was like, if I'd have said the same fucking thing, like, fuck it up.
Yeah.
Y'all were like, OJ,
Ray,
OJ,
Ray, Ray. Ray.
You got a bottle thrown at you and shit.
Man. But anyway, man, all right, let's see. Oh, shit, we did this an hour just now.
Nice.
We only, believe it or not, we'd only done like less than half an hour before. So we already gone twice as long.
Dang.
Yeah.
Shazam.
I know, man. It gets out of hand sometimes.
Yeah.
But shit. Well, alright, man. Well, man. It's been a great episode. I'm sure you already know. We all will say something at the end. So, man, you got anything else you want to contribute?
Well, I was glad to be on the show, and hopefully I'll be here next Friday.
Sounds good to me, man. This was very, very enjoyable, man.
Nah, I mean, we can't be having Jews on here all the time.
Fuck you, man. It's gonna happen.
Jews, I'm not an anti.
We're taking over.
Okay, I'm not an anti-Semite, but I am. I don't know.
It'll be alright. We'll make it work.
So yeah, so like, I don't hate Jews, but I don't necessarily agree with them all the time.
Okay. I feel that way about every person on the
planet. I feel that way about niggas too.
Yeah. That's just a human thing, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're humans. We're all humans. Humans.
Well, alright, man, you got it.
You know where I'm going with this. In case of apocalypse, I want you to go ahead
and kill your children.
And snuff your children. That's right, D. I know what you're thinking. You're like, Drew, that's fucked up. Those are my kids.
But it's the best thing for them.
Yeah, you gotta see.
But you won't push the button.
No.
See how fucked up that is? Yeah.
No, because that's me.
Is that because I got selfish. A son? I want to do that. Selfish. You know, I'm not going to do this selfish. To everybody. Selfish. But you snuff them out in the zombie apocalypse.
Because I get to continue to live and kill. I get to continue to live and kill zombies, thank you very much, selfish. Which I would enjoy to do. If I push the button, I'll just cease to exist.
You're even sicker than us.
You interrupt me all the time, D. I'm tired of it. This is my fucking sign out. It's a good fucking sign out. You had to interrupt it and fuck it all up.
I'm sorry, man.
So this is what's going to happen. This is what's going down.
I know it's kind of an abusive relationship, man.
I'm tired of standing up for myself. You're going to shut the fuck up. I'm going to finish this shit.
Take your foot off the white man's neck.
You're going to shut your ass up, too. Because you fucking don't even know what a sign out is, bitch. With your weak ass sign out. You just shut the fuck up. I can easily ruin your shit. Okay, motherfucker? Natalie Portman was a fine pitch.
Whatever, go ahead.
She killed Jack Nicholson and both of the Baldwin brothers.
Nah, but see, mine's an actual fact, man. Yours is just an opinion. Ooh.
It's still an opinion towards the end.
No, okay. No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
So, on the sign-off, you know what I'm saying? What are you supposed to do? Leave an important fact.
Well, we
you got anything else you want to add.
And mine usually changed up, and D's already always stayed the same, and I kind of like that D's stayed the same because it started becoming kind of more of a goal.
It's my catchphrase.
Like, yeah. So, I decided I think I'd do one, too. But, of course, I couldn't do one similar to D's, so I went in a different direction with it.
I just be fucking with him, man. He gets mad.
You would know, I get mad because you interrupt me. It's like, go ahead and sign out. Okay, now I'm going to talk through your whole fucking sign out. You son of a bitch. And now the sign out, it's like, it's kind of rude. It's like lost its mojo. So now if I like go to say the sign out again, like it's not going to have that mojo like
just
it
say
usually
something
does.
Else, dude.
Marilyn Monroe was a fine bitch. She killed two Kennedy brothers.
See, you can't even do that right, man. Come on, man.
She killed Lou Gehrig and both Kennedy brothers. Okay. I guess so my sign out would be this. Fuck everything. Fuck how I feel. Fuck how you feel. Fuck your opinions. Fuck what you think's right. Fuck what you think's wrong. Fuck the fact that you're upset that your kid died. Fuck the fact that your kid's still living. You know, just basically fuck it all. And, you know, basically, if you're doing right in your life, and what I mean by right is not what humankind considers right, it's what you as an individual considers right, then you're doing something right. So, you know, sometimes you gotta get out there, eat some pussy, suck some dick, and kick some ass.
Nice. Well, we're gonna change things up a little bit this week. I got something very important to say. And that is that Marilyn Monroe was a fine bitch. She killed Lou Gehrig and both the Kennedy brothers. So stay out that fine bitch pussy. Get you some regular pussy. We're over.
We're out.
Big black dicks, motherfucker! I'm not going to interrupt your dick time.
Thank you! Peter, penis. Peter, papa, papa, penis. Big black dicks, motherfucker.
He said, smoke up, Tony. It's great.